We build fast motorcycles. I really enjoy building hot rod Harleys. We can start from scratch or an old bike that needs to be completely torn down. Well, after we decide what we want to do, we usually just disassemble the bike and find out exactly what we need to do as far as repairs or welding, machine work, order the parts, and then start doing all the machining, painting, powder coating, and reassembling the motorcycle. Well, it's a 79 FLH. It's got a 92 cubic inch stroker motor, all hand assembled. It's all degreed, balanced, blueprinted. Thunderjet on the carburetor, custom paint. The best part of it for me is when we finally start it up and I get to listen to it and see the look on the customer's face. That's what I enjoy the most.
They're just gracious old ladies, I think, you know. They're just hanging in there for us to come make them pretty again.
Historic homes of Springfield, a secret passage to yesteryear. Time has taken its toll on some of the houses, but all is not lost. Meet Shirley Akampora. In 1995, Shirley and her husband John bought this North Laura Street home. A home they put their labor of love in to restore. 2 years down and hopefully 2 months to go.
We actually had to go out and buy the rails and spindles and reconstruct this whole step here. Lots of labor, you know. The house had good bones to start with, so we had that to work around.
Their countless hours of stripping paint, putting up wallpaper, and repainting has paid off.
It's a lot of work, but it's rewarding.
This home reminds John Akampora of his childhood.
Everybody had an old house like this when we were kids.
A little patience, sweat, and teamwork also helped Carol and Arnold Bennett fulfill their dream. It all went a long way in helping them restore their 90-year-old great colonial home.
When you buy a house like this, you can do what you want to do with it. You've always sort of had a dream of what you'd like to do and never had the opportunity.
If these walls had the opportunity to talk, they would tell the story of owners who fade away, leaving only memories of the past. Old homes with new faces, people dedicated to clinging on to a piece of the past. Homes like these have thousands of stories to tell, and on some days, if you listen very closely, they'll talk.
It has the warmth of other people before us, and when I cross on the floor and hear a crack on the floor or move a piece of furniture and the wall cracks or a window kind of shakes and you think,
The Bennetts hope Springfield will once again become family-oriented. There's crime, drugs, neighbors complain of prostitution.
I think it takes a special type of person to move down into this area, but we look at the long range.
A beautiful house will hopefully mean a beautiful neighborhood. These folks believe it will happen, one house at a time. Ted White, ABC 25 Tonight. It's another day at the office for Mark Schultz and Mike Hackett. An office with plenty of space and windows. Mark and Mike's job allows them to have a little fun. It's a combination of window washing and rappelling down some of Jacksonville's tallest buildings.
There's all kinds of ways to get to a window, and we have to figure out how to do it.
It was a thrill of the heights. I like the heights, and just gives adrenaline flow. It's excitement and you get paid pretty good money doing it.
Mike and Mark both agree it's hard work.
Yeah.
But there are fringe benefits.
I like it because it's peaceful. You don't have to worry about anybody up here. You know, you can see everything, all the sights and stuff.
And with the good comes the bad.
This is ridiculous, dude. Every time I move, it gets stuck.
Mike and Mark each have a decade of experience behind their squeegees. Both clearly remember their first day on the job.
Tell you the truth, it really didn't scare me. The very first job I did with Southern Bell, I was looking at pictures of other people doing this, and it got me excited.
But Mark was a little less excited. He said,
"Oh my God, I'm gonna die."
They've mastered the art of cleaning dirty windows. Wash on, wipe off.
What I like most about it, all the attention you get from the people.
They're being watched, and based on what some people leave on the windows, they're also being admired.
We've had notes and stuff stuck on the glass, numbers.
And then there's the people who have plenty of jokes.
Oh, you missed a spot here, or work hard, you know, just typical things like that.
Mark and Mike have a job where their life is literally hanging by a string, but they say it's an opportunity to look at life from a different angle. Ted White, ABC 25 Tonight. Once again, Halloween is near, where ghouls and goblins instill their fear. Kids will knock door to door and go street to street with just a few tricks in mind and a lot of treats. Shoppers young and old are out looking for last-minute costumes for Friday night. This woman and her companion will be an interesting sight.
I'm dressed up as half woman, half man. He's going as Darth Vader, so it's going to be kind of an interesting duo. Oh.
Some hope to dress like creatures from the depths of hell, unlike this 9-year-old Southern Belle. How about a mask with a head that's shrinking, or a skeleton where everyone knows what he's thinking?
Well, a lot of people have been coming in asking for vampires and werewolves. That this year it's been like really popular. Stuff that's like really dark and evil.
Searching for some makeup to look half alive, or perhaps a member of the Jackson 5. Halloween is hours away. Do you have a costume this season? This woman does, and she'll celebrate for a couple of reasons.
It's a little bit unusual for me because it's my birthday, so I use it as an occasion to doubly celebrate.
This Jaguars cheerleader wants a costume that says home. She may end up going out as a Flintstone. If you plan on renting a costume, better not wait.
Okay, young lady, you're coming back Sunday. Don't be late.
Most of all for Halloween, try to have some fun. It's only once a year. Let your imaginations run. For ABC 25, I'm Ted White. And may your Halloween be filled with fright.